This is what a typical unsignalized four-way intersection looks like in the US, with each vehicle having to come to a complete stop in order to proceed. However, alternative intersection designs can improve traffic flow. One popular alternative around the world is a roundabout. Here's a diagram of a typical single-lane roundabout. Pavement markings at the entry notify drivers to yield. Splitter islands separate the lane directions. The center island helps reduce the driver's speed by blocking the other side of the road. The apron helps large trucks turn by giving them extra room. Avoid driving next to large vehicles. In the US, counterclockwise circulation is used. The landscape buffer gives pedestrians space away from the traveling vehicles. Pedestrian crossings are placed at each entrance perpendicular to the roadway. Here's an aerial view of traffic flow through a roundabout. Vehicles enter the circle moving counterclockwise around a center island by yielding to vehicles in the circle, as well as pedestrians, to reach their exit. Traffic flow is continuous, however vehicles proceed with caution and at low speed.
Here's how to correctly approach a roundabout. Notice the sign on the right shows, for the first and second exit, use the right lane. For the second, third, or U-turn, use the left lane. Yield to any car circling inside. If making an immediate right turn, enter using the right lane, then proceed to your exit. If going straight through the roundabout, enter from either lane, pass the first exit, and take the second one out. If planning to make a U-turn, enter from the left lane and travel completely around the circle. Be cautious of pedestrians while traveling inside a circle. If a pedestrian is waiting to cross as you reach your exit, come to a complete stop and allow them to pass. As a pedestrian, approach the crosswalk with caution and proceed when safe. Ensure incoming cars are stopped before continuing.
There are a couple options for traversing a roundabout by bike. If permitted, you may enter the circle and use the full lane after yielding to reach your exit. Another option for bicyclists is to utilize the crosswalk. Here in the US, we typically only see traditional style roundabouts, but all across the world, roundabouts can take many different forms. Here's some footage of what is known as the Magic Roundabout in Swindon, England. This seven circle roundabout may seem too complicated at first, but it's been working for over 60 years. In a traditional roundabout, traffic moves in one direction, but here, traffic flows in both directions, with an inner circle that allows for drivers to quickly reach their exit. In addition to this, drivers can also take multiple routes to reach their exit in order to avoid traffic. Shown here is probably the most famous roundabout in the world, at the Arc de Triomphe in Paris, France. 12 arterial streets all converge at this circle with no traffic signals or lane markers. What makes this roundabout work is that the yielding rules are reversed. Cars entering the circle have the right of way with the assistance of traffic cops at the intersections, and cars in the circle must yield to these cars people may call this roundabout the worst in the world, as severe congestion and accidents often occur. However, very few cause injury, and with so many streets converging to one area, any other traffic pattern is almost impossible. The only current proposed solutions to the traffic problems here include a congested area toll for vehicles, similar to the one in London, England, and a cable car running across the city to hopefully reduce overall vehicular traffic.